Okay, there was somebody on Aaron's forum, on his Tarsashi forum, talking about the 1266 and how good he did with it. And he's an English hunter over in England. And I thought I would get my old 1266 out and just make, I've never done the video with it. I haven't had this one long. I just picked it up actually from a buddy of mine. But this is one of the first 1266s. Had the dual board in it before they went to the single board. And then the batteries, they drop in, but you gotta clip them on instead of just having the contacts in the bottom. But it's still a very powerful metal detector. And I had one of these back in the 90s. Probably this exact one. Not this one, but I mean, exact, you know, the two board model. And I used it for a long time. I dug a lot of deep three ringers with it. But when I used to run it, I used to think it was one of the hardest metal detectors to run compared to other ones because they were so choppy. But I've been using it here lately. And to me now, after running, you know, another 25 years of different metal detectors, and some that's way more powerful, it's actually very easy to run and seems very intuitive compared to what I used to remember. To me, it runs just like the 1236 with the silencer turned off, and acts just like the 1236 in iron. And I really like the 1236 in iron with a 5-inch coil for picking an iron. And this does the same thing. But I'll just run it. This is a sight right here. It's got a lot of iron in it. And I'll just sweep around for a minute and let you hear some of the targets and what it runs. And by the way, I've got this thing wide open. The sensitivity's wide open with the boost turned on. And volume's wide open. And see, when you get these old, and I've got the disc up about 4.75. That'll get rid of a big nail. There's a lot of iron in here, and some of it'll try to break through. But it don't sound clean. I know a long time ago, every one of them targets would stop me in my tracks. That piece of iron too, and almost fool you. This is an old house site right here, so. That's a big piece of iron. See how it wants to sound good that way? It's a very intuitive machine. It's just got a fixed ground balance. And if I turn the discriminator low enough, one piece of iron. If I turn the discriminator low enough, it'll start actually picking up the mineral. I mean, it'll just go crazy on the soil. It's not really one of the type of machines you can go in and adjust the ground balance. It'll throw everything off inside the machine, all the discrimination. And like, here's a bunch of big iron here, right here I've dug. And you can, but see how you can play with it for a minute? See how it breaks up? That's a big pile of it. You can just tell it's big iron. See? That's faulting off the nail. If these things had some way to ground bounce, they would really be deep. These are just all, I mean, them sounds, oh, but you know it's rejected targets. That's a real target. See how much cleaner it is? But like, I got my 10-inch dime over here, but I doubt you'd ever try to dig it. But try to dig it, it's laying right here under my marker, right there. So you would even never know it was there. I mean, if you find it, it's got that fuzzy hit, but. You would never chase that target right there. There's a real target. There's a big piece of iron right back there. But it's a very intuitive machine. Nowadays, especially after running a lot of high-powered machines, this machine was so powerful at the time it came out, it was hard to run. But here's a nail board test for it. And you can see that's the big nail. See, I just don't want to hang to it. But I'll put the penny in the middle. There's some angles that just like. So that sounds like a nail down the barrel. You would never. But I've got these different coils here. And that nail board test is nothing for this coil right here, this little 3-inch. And there's nothing for the 5-inch. And I can put this 10.5 on here. And that dime sounds a little better, but it's still not nothing you'd wanna probably dig, not in this soil. But now you're getting good soil, and the machine's really deep. I mean, it won't hit that 10-inch dime, and that's 4 or 5 bar dirt, but you get down there, you know, 2 bar dirt, and even less. Especially, you know, good dirt, and it's really deep. It's a deep metal detector. I don't know. Let me see. I don't even know if you can hear it. But this is just a zinc penny. Let's see if you can. Hear that whisper? That's about 18 inches. But you'd have to have good dirt. Because if you got dirt where the metal detector will keep on chattering while you're running it, like that threshold, compared to, see how mine goes quiet on the ground? If you got dirt that you can get that threshold just to stay sizzling the whole time, and it's sort of like on these Vista X's, or I mean any of the Vistas, or you know, a lot of the modern machines, that you crank them up and they start getting that threshold. You can actually hold that threshold on the soil, even if it's bad soil, because you can choose the ground balance. You know, neutralize the soil with a ground balance so you can keep that sizzle going and get that extra depth out of it. But anyway, I thought I'd show this machine. I mean, it runs perfect, and it's 30 years old now. Fixing to be 30 years old. But, because that's the 91 model, I believe it is. And the depth is still outrageous by modern day standards. It's just limited because it doesn't have a ground balance. And I've played with the ground balances before on 1266s. But they start getting a little weird acting in the discrimination circuit. Like the factory knew the right place to set it to make the discriminator work right. But anyway, I just thought I'd do this video. Well, I appreciate it.